In this and in the remaining lessons for the course, we turn our attention to the study of polynomial algorithms. First, however, a little perspective. In the beginning of the course, we defined the general notion of a language. Then, we began to distinguish between decidable languages and undecidable ones. Remember that there are uncountably many undecidable ones, but only uncountably many decidable ones. In comparison, then, the decidable ones should be infinitesimally small, but I'll give them this big circle here anyway, because they're so interesting to us. In the section of the course on complexity, we considered several subclasses of the decidable languages. P, which consists of those languages decidable in polynomial time. NP, which consists of those languages that can be verified in polynomial time. And within this, we have this little band of NP-complete problems, which are the hardest problems in NP. If any one of these turned out to be polynomial, then P would expand and swallow all of NP, or equivalently, we can think of NP collapsing down into this class P. In this section, we're going to focus on this class P, the set of polynomially decidable languages. The overall tone here will hopefully feel a little more optimistic. In the previous sections of the course, many of our results were of a negative nature. No, you can't decide that language. Or, no, that problem isn't tractable unless P is equal to NP. Here, the results will be entirely positive. No longer will we be excluding problems from a good class. We'll just be showing that problems are in this good class, P. Yes, you can do that in polynomial time. Or, it's even a low-order polynomial, and we can solve huge instances in practice.